Hello dear students, in today's video we are going to start with one of the important concept in chapter motion, which is also important in terms of your IGCSC physics paper, that is motion graphs. As I said, this topic is important for your IGCSC exam. That's because most of IGCSC past papers, they contain at least one question related to motion graphs. So please pay attention to this video as well as next two videos related to motion graphs, wherein we will be discussing in detail what type of motion graphs we have and what kind of questions you will be asked on motion graphs. In this video we are going to discuss about basics of graphs. So what do we mean by graphs? Graphs are nothing but a representation of the set of data that is given to us. So whatever data that is given to us to show the relationship between the data, or how one data depends on another data, to represent that in a graphical form, we use graphs. As I said, graphs also describes how one quantity changes with respect to another quantity. For example, we have learned in our previous videos that force and acceleration, they are directly proportional to each other. If force increases, velocity of the body changes and it is into the acceleration. So we know that force and acceleration are directly proportional. I have written some values for force over here and how the values of acceleration will change based on these values of force. As we know that when two quantities are in direct proportion, whatever ratio in which one quantity changes, another quantity follows the same ratio. So if the value of force is doubled, even the value of acceleration will be doubled. We are representing these two values in graphical form now. We know that graph has two axes, that is an x-axis and y-axis. One of the quantity from here will be represented on x-axis and another will be represented on y-axis. We have represented acceleration on x-axis and force on y-axis. Please note, how do we have to level the axis? While leveling the axis, we have to write quantity along with its unit. So to represent acceleration on x-axis, I have written a along with unit for acceleration, that is meter per second square. Similarly, on y-axis, we have written force along with unit of force, that is Newton. Most of the time, it is explicitly given in your paper which quantity you have to represent on y-axis and which quantity you have to represent on x-axis. But if it is not given in your paper, then you should be selecting a quantity which is independent of other quantity, and that should go on x-axis. For example, if I am having table written for distance and time, then time being independent quantity, it will be represented on x-axis and distance shall be represented on y-axis. In this case, force and acceleration, both of them are dependent on each other, and hence it does not matter if I write force on y-axis or on x-axis. I hope you are cleared with basic idea of the graphs. Now we will be representing these values given in the table on the graph. Note that we have first value for force 0 and first value for acceleration 0. So the point will be plotted over here, and this is the correct way to plot the point. You have two ways to plot the point: either a circle with dot, or you can represent a point with a small cross. No other way is allowed to plot points on the graph. Second value we have is 5 units of force and 5 units for acceleration. If I consider these two points as 5 units for each, then the point will be plotted somewhere here. Similarly, for next value, that is 10 units for force and 10 units for acceleration, the point will be plotted over here. For 15 units of force and 15 units for acceleration, point will be somewhere here and the last value will be somewhere here. Now, all of these points are at different levels, and to represent them uniformly, we will be joining them with a line passing through all the points. How do we draw that line? We can simply draw that line like this. So here we have drawn a line passing through all the points. Now, note that as force and acceleration, they are directly proportional to each other, the line is a straight line passing through the origin. So for every quantities, those are directly proportional to each other, the graph for those quantities will be a straight line passing through the origin. Now we will be discussing about what is gradient of the graph. In simple words, gradient of the graph is nothing but slope of the graph. How steep the line is nothing but gradient. So imagine here we are having this line as one of the example. If I draw another line which is something like this, you can understand that this line is a steeper line than this one. So this steepness of the line is nothing but its gradient. We have a mathematical formula to calculate gradient of the graph. Note that same formula you will be using in mathematics as well, wherein you will be again studying about motion graphs. So please remember this formula. Formula for the gradient of graph is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Now what is this y2, y1, x2, x1? These are nothing but coordinates of random points that we can choose to calculate the gradient. Suppose I choose this point as my second point and I choose this point as my first point. So coordinates for this point will be x2 and y2, and coordinate for this point will be x1, y1. I will be taking these values to calculate gradient of this line. You can understand that value of y2 over here is 20 and value of y1 over here is 10. So in my numerator, I will be having y2 as 20, y1 as 10. Whereas x2 here will be 20 again and x1 here will be 10. So in the numerator, it will be 20 minus 10, and in the denominator also, it will be 20 minus 10. You will calculate that value and you will reach to a number. Now note that since we are using two different values of force, I can also represent this formula as F2 minus F1, because on y-axis we are representing force. And in the denominator, I can write as A2 minus A1 because on x-axis we are representing acceleration. So the same formula can be rewritten as F2 minus F1 upon A2 minus A1 for this particular graph and not for any other graph. Difference between two quantities is also represented by letter delta. The small triangle that you can see here is nothing but delta, and delta is nothing but difference in the values. So 20 minus 10 represents difference in the value of force, so it will be written as delta F, and A2 minus A1 will represent difference in the value of acceleration, so it can be written as delta A. So here we are getting delta F upon delta A. We have learned that formula for force is F equals to M into A. Then what will be the value of M? M can be given as F upon A, that is force upon acceleration. Similar thing you have calculated over here in the gradient of this graph. So what do you understand over here? Gradient of this graph, that is F2 minus F1 upon A2 minus A1, will be nothing but mass of the quantity for which you are calculating force and acceleration. So note that gradient of the graph may lead you to a quantity that is calculated from the formula given.